the last real big hit out before the games, and I want to get an edge over my competitors.
The level of windsurfer in RS6 class, it's really high and it's quite difficult to defend this title.
The competition here in Perth is top. There's no one missing from the world's best, and it's going to be an awesome race.
I think the spectators, you know, watching the 40, are going to see plenty of action. There's going to be, you know, big breeze, big waves.
It's going to be exciting, and anybody could win this event.
Beautiful Perth in Western Australia is playing host to the biggest international sailing regatta this year. 1,200 sailors from 79 nations competing in 800 boats. 10 world titles will be decided off the coast of Fremantle on 6 courses at this combined championship, one for each of the Olympic sailing classes. It's an impressive event that happens every 4 years, and sailors call it quite simply the world's. Pressure on the top athletes is intense because this is the main qualifier for the Olympic regatta. All are here to pull out a top performance at the Perth 2011 ISAF Sailing World Championships. It's crunch time for all 5 remaining fleets here battling for World Championship honours. The star class is down to the top 10 medal race finale, which will be our main feature coming up. In the RSX men's class, Dorian van Rysselberg is leading Poland's Piotr Miszka and will feature their race later in the show. In the 470 women's fleet, Spain's Tara Pacheco and Berta Betanzos are now 13 points clear of Japan's Ai Kondo and Wakako Tabata. And the 49ers are near the end of their epic 15 race series. Brits Pink and Peacock are now only 2 points clear of Australians Outeridge and Jensen in second overall. Australia is also looking strong in the men's laser class, where Tom Slingsby has 5 wins from 8 races, with second place Paul Goodison, the gold medalist from Beijing, now 11 points behind. Tomorrow is a massive day for those 4 fleets, all contending their top 10 medal race decider in quickfire succession. But right now, the big men of star sailing are stepping up to the plate. The Star has been described as the finishing school for Olympic sailors. It's been in the game since 1932, and this fleet alone can count 11 Olympic medals and 10 world champions.
I'm standing aboard the Olympic class Star boat. It's a 22-foot long two-man keel boat, the last of the two-man keel boats in the Olympics. Back here, we've got the runners and the check stays. Console back in here. For the both the crew to adjust all the controls, main sheet, outboard, Cunningham. The boats are actually designed in 1911, 100 years old this year. Back then there was wooden masts, it's now aluminium, and the boats are reasonably high-tech composite construction now as opposed to wood back in the old days. It's the class for the big boys. The crew weight limit is 200 kilos, 100 kilos each, and it's a pretty tough fleet. There's a huge sail area for the size boat it is and for the weight of the boat. It's fully powered up in 7 knots. Anything above that, you're depowering, and in 20 to 25, like we would expect here, it's moderately frightening.
Yeah. Quality and experience in strength and depth is how the star class is regarded worldwide. Some of the biggest names in professional sailing come back time and again to try and win the Star Worlds, and only a few succeed. And here in Perth, it's been a challenging week. First, the defending Olympic champions pulled up when skipper Ian Percy damaged his back, and then several of the main contenders blew races and sailed themselves out of contention. But at the top of the pile, Brazil's most famous sailor, Robert Scheid, a man with two Olympic golds and two silvers, eased away to give himself an easy ride into today's medal race. Behind him, the Americans, Germans, Swedes and Poles will be scrapping for the podium.
Robert Scheid, no question, one of the greatest sailors in the world.
I think I'm quite a simple guy. I like simple things, simple food. I like to hang out with my family, with my son, which is 2 years old now, my wife, which is also a sailor, she sails laser radio. And when I was young, I played tennis, swimming, a lot of mountain biking, scuba diving. So I'm very into sports because of my family. My father was also a very good sportsman, and he led us into that.
The Brazilian sailing legend, heading off to the right-hand side, Robert Scheid. Two gold and two Olympic silver in his repertoire.
After I got the second gold in Athens, there was a big media exposure of myself, and then I got kind of famous. So sometimes after that, when I went to shopping malls and so on, people asked my autograph and take pictures and so on. It's not that I'm so popular as a football player, but I'm recognized in my country, and that's great to have. The biggest achievement for me, it's not just the final prize, to get a medal, it's the process of getting better, to know that we know more about the boat, that we are faster, that our maneuvers are better, that we have more knowledge about meteorology, about sails, about masts. So to get better as a sailor, it's what is the biggest achievement for me. I think the medal race is good. It's a good format because people will get closer, will watch more and will understand more. It's a quick race, a lot can happen. Some situations are tough for the competitors because, for instance, if one guy is leading and the second guy is the only one who can beat him, that puts a lot of pressure on the second guy because then the first guy can match race the second and open the game for the third and fourth and fifth to pass the second. So I think in that case, it's not so fair for the competition. But it's good for our sport and for the exposure.
A good insight there from the main man. Let's catch up with the contenders before the medal race itself.
Well, it's always tough to go to these medal races because it's very quick. Everything happens really quick. So we have a good advantage, but it's never over till it's over. So we've got to finish the job today, and we focus on trying to do that.
Yeah, for us, we just want to finish in the top three, and we're in second now, so hopefully we can hang on.
A good performance yesterday. You're happy with the way things are going, and what are you expecting out there on course today?
Oh, we're very happy with the place now, and yeah, it's going to be very tight between the second, third and fourth place overall, so it's going to be a tough race.
Final countdown. Big, heavy boat starting to accelerate now, just behind the line. I can see Brazil halfway down the line. I can see the Americans this side of the Brazilian boat. Ah, interesting. I just saw the Swedish sailor head off to the right-hand side of the course. Just as we were saying, he's thinking, well, there's no point in me following the pack. Going to go out on my own and hope they get caught up in a fight. Early stages of the Star Medal Race. Yellow dot on the sail. That is Robert Scheid and USA 8267, the team that could spoil his day and take his world title. Left-hand side, up top of the screen, is the Polish team. But then Scheid, Mendelblatt and the Germans, Staniek and Kleen. And that's showing that the Germans are in second place at the moment. Stay like that with the Americans there. Silver goes to Germany. And there we have the ones that are holding our interest at the moment. Or certainly the Germans and the Brazilians. Middle of picture there. Super shot. Look at that technique.
Well, there we see the crews with their feet under the hiking straps trying to swing the boat down. The wind is forcing the boat to heel, and by leaning out, hiking as we call it, they're trying to keep the boat as flat as possible or upright. And this is the strenuous part. This is where the physical action comes in. You can see there Mark Mendelblatt, he's got the tiller extension in his hand, but his crew is hanging over the side trying to swing the boat down.
As they come in, and what a spectacular sight this is. They're all coming in very, very close together here. And it, the first boat that's going to round as far as a medal contender is concerned, and you're right, as they head round the mark, it is Poland that round first. Well, not going to win a medal. Went way out to the left-hand side of the racetrack, but let's have a look behind. It's a German team. Staniek, well, he's having a surprise package of an event. He is second. The Germans round the mark in second. That would take him to silver medal position. Norway. But just behind Norway, Robert Scheid in fourth. He doesn't need to be that good, but that would take him to the world title. And the Americans are struggling. At the moment, the USA are in bronze medal position.
Well, yes, we see these stars. They go fast downwind, and they sail angles like a laser would. A very, very physical boat. You can see the helms pumping the sail, the crew rolling the boat. And they're so close together. I don't think we've seen a fleet in a medal race this close together. And whereas the leaders of the race are extending, the battle for the medals, well, that's full on.
Well, if you wanted some mental exercise, I think these scores are going to give you it. We'll do the adding up for you. But Kuznirovits is leading for Poland. But there are some new names coming up the front, and some of the favourites are medal contenders. Slip right back. OK, next part of the story. There are two marks. They can choose which one they go round. And as Shirley Robinson was saying, generally this week, it's been favoured to go towards the wall.
And it looks like they'll go over there. And it's not to get the cheers of the crowd, Richard. It's because there's favoured wind coming down that side. And that's the side the Americans came downwind.
Robert Scheid is round in fourth place. And the Germans... There's an issue down there. There could have been a collision down there at the bottom of the mark. Bang, in the middle of those boats. The American sandwich from going from right to left. Look, he can't get out. French team on either side. He wants to turn. He can't turn. And he's behind both of them, forced way around the outside. Not only slowed down, what does he do? Almost stops. And now he's behind the French boat with the bad air coming off their sails. And when you're fighting for a medal, that is something you absolutely despair of. The Americans are in seventh now. Staniek and Kleen second. So that is silver. Loof is fourth. Well, as Freddie Loof finishes fourth, that will give him 66 points. And this is an interesting battle here between America and Sweden. It's good news for the American supporters because at one point up this leg, Sweden were looking like they were going to pounce into a podium place. But the Americans have gone over, they've covered them, they're defending their position. Mendelblatt said he wanted to be on the podium. At the moment, he still is.
Just. Freddie Loof, two times world champion, been in his class for a long, long time. He's putting the squeeze on the Americans, and you can bet your life these two are going to fight it out down this next run.
So now it's Mendelblatt time to play games. This is not about a race to him, it's about a head-to-head confrontation. This is Sweden against America. This is America saying, we want the podium place and we are going to stop you getting it. Mendelblatt did a good blocking job. Interesting, when we spoke to Robert Scheid earlier, who was talking about the medal race, it's far from straightforward as Loof jibes, throws the boom over, and the wind's now coming from the right, which he has right away. Quick reaction on the Americans' boat. They don't want to get caught out. Now, as far as the Americans, it's about staying out of trouble and keeping Loof towards the back. But as it is, well, it's a bronze medal for the American team. But now it's a short, what, 50, 60, 70 metres in front of the crowds. They're out of picture, the grandstands watching the Polish sailor. There won't be big celebrations, but they'll be pleased to end on a high. Robert Scheid is on his way, though. Well, the Brazilian team went out today in contention, more than contention for a gold medal. They were the favourites. It's silver for Germany. The German team secure silver, but the world champion in the star class punches the air from Brazil, Robert Scheid and Bruno Prada. They've sailed an outstanding regatta. They celebrate an achievement out here in the waters of Perth. They could have lost it today. They kept their cool. They delivered really what everyone expected. Gold for Brazil. Freddie Loof, close. Tried hard. It was always an uphill struggle. Crosses the line. no reaction. Behind them, the American team.
A little bit disappointed, I would imagine.
That's a smile, acknowledgement, not celebrations. It may feel better a little later on.
It's always very tense, you know, these medal races, everything happens so quick, and I think we manage. We manage our nerves, and we manage to hold our position well. Fifth place was enough to get a gold, so we're really pleased, really happy.
And Perth has delivered the conditions we were hoping for. Confirmation, that is. Bronze, United States of America. Germany secure silver, best performance of their sailing lives in the Star. And gold went to the champion. Robert Scheid and Bruno Prada came here with not too much to do, but they did it in such style, such composure, and never engaged in a scrap.
What a way to end a world championship. We'll be back in a moment with the RSX men making their moves for that all-important medal race cut. Welcome back to Western Australia and the Perth 2011 ISAF Sailing World Championships, where 1,200 sailors are fighting it out for world title honours and Olympic selection. The wind is coming in strong here on the penultimate day of the championship, perfect for all board sports, including the RSX men's class coming up. Let's head to the beach now and catch up with the colourful characters leading this class.
I'm really, really excited to do it. Really want to start. Just do my best. Some good start, some good race, and just come as better as possible for tomorrow, for the real one.
Yeah, medal race day tomorrow. Do you think you can catch Dorian?
I'm sure about it.
The doctor finally showed up, so everybody's really stoked. You can see everybody's getting a little bit antsy, so it's going to be glamour racing.
Well, this is the final countdown to the start in the men's RSX. 3, 2, 1, go! Well, it's one of the most spectacular sights in Olympic sailing. An even split. Somehow they all get through that gap. And the majority are heading at speed towards the far side, the left-hand side of the course. France lead, Norway second, Korea are there too. And Dorian van Rosenberg is leading this fleet. This is the last race before only the top 10 will go into the medal race final. That's tomorrow. That's when the world champion will be decided. But this afternoon, it is just glorious conditions here. Well, that's Poland 82. Mieszka, second at the start of play today. Second after race 9 today. Heading into the first mark at speed with an advantage of about 70, 80 metres, it's Mierzynski. Fourth at the beginning of play today. He is leading this race. Mieszka's chasing his fellow countrymen. That carries on like this. Poland could be top of the leaderboard after 10 races. It was a head downwind at speed. We have New Zealand 151. That's Jean-Paul Tobin. He's chasing Tom Ashley, trying to put Ashley under pressure for Olympic selection. But what a sight that is. Poland 1 and 2 at the front, and the Kiwi sailor is making progress behind. Wind the strongest it's been all afternoon. Mierzynski leads. Well, this is the Polish 1-2 heading up towards the top mark. Behind, Great Britain is on the tack. In the back of the fleet, the Dutch sailor van Rieselberg is in trouble, 19th. Well, this is the battle right at the front of the men's RSX. Poland 1-2-6, Mierzynski rounds in first position. Fellow countryman, though, is putting pressure on him. Mieszka, second at the beginning of the day. This is van Rieselberg. This is the man under pressure. This is the man who potentially could be heading for his worst result in the series, and that's just what he doesn't want. He's giving absolutely everything. He was in 16th when we last saw him. Well, he's under pressure. At the moment, he would lose the overall lead. This is the battle for third in this race. Great Britain's Nick Dempsey, he is not going to qualify for the medal race tomorrow. He will not be in the top 10. But Julien Bonton, if he stays like this in third, is on target to get in the medal race. In 10th, the Israeli Mashish, but in 13th and fighting through the feet, the overall leader, Van Rischenberg. What's that, 12, 13 metres between them? At the moment, it is advantage to Mazinski. Mashish is chasing. What a sight this is now. At the end of the day, the breeze at its strongest. One more shot, one more jibe, and then to the finish line. Mazinski jibes, good jibe. Mirska just behind. Well, 10 metres between the two of them, they're heading for the finish. Mazinski will win this race. They've had an epic battle around the race course. Mazinski first and second, Mirska, and that will take Mirska to the top of the leaderboard, unless the Dutch sailor really gains on the last, what, two, three legs. And here he is, Dorian van Rooselberg. Well, has he done enough? Heading down towards the finish. He's in 10th place, he's in 9th at the moment. Well, if he's in 9th, he will lose the overall lead. Julien Bonton from France, this should secure his place in the medal race final, but for Dempsey, even 4th in this race, he'll be going home tomorrow. But van Rooselberg has caught up, but not enough to keep his overall lead. The point score now, the man from the Netherlands goes into second place, just 1 point off the lead. Well, he heads for home, contemplating a day that could have been so different. Tomorrow is likely to be a head-to-head. Because right at the top of the leaderboard, Poland and Netherlands, just 1 point apart. But any of the top four could still win gold. Fifth and sixth overall, a chance for a medal. The man smiling, though, is from Poland.
I'm first, I'm really happy. And I think I have already the medal, so tomorrow I will focus 100% to defend my first place, defend my title from the last year.
Western Australia is famous for its winemaking in Margaret River, so we took two 49er competitors from the States for a whistle-stop tour.
All right. Oh my God, this is awesome.
Eric Stork and Trevor Moore had the chance to meet the man behind Lewin Estate, Dennis Horgan.
Nice to meet you. A couple of yanks, having a good sail around the place, are you?
Yeah.
This was one of the first vineyards to be planted in 1975, and the climate has proved perfect for growing grapes.
It's been an absolute incredible journey, and I mean, to sit here at lunch at Lewin Estates after just taking a chopper ride all the way from Fremantle, Australia. I mean, that just is the tip of the iceberg. It's just, it's been unbelievable.
The 49ers enjoyed thrilling racing this afternoon, and our American friends have made the medal race cut in sixth place. But it's all changed at the top. Australians Outeridge and Jensen stormed to the front ahead of the Brits Pink and Peacock, and the Danish Toft Nielsen brothers now in second place. Incredibly, French sailors from all 10 classes have qualified their country for the Olympics, including 470 women, Dereau and Petitjean. Petitjean just missed the medal race cut, but Spain's Pacheco and Betanzos have pulled away at the top of the leaderboard. Three poor results saw Japan's Kondo and Tabata drop to fifth overall. Following today's star medal race, this is how the President's Cup country table stands. And finally, laser gold medalist Paul Goodison had a poor day, dropping to sixth on the leaderboard. Tom Slingsby is still flying the flag for Australia going into the medal races, impressing Aussie cricket legend Justin Langer.
It's really great to see such an international flavour on our waters, so I'm very proud of this whole event. I'm really looking forward to seeing Tom hold the flag and wave the flag for Australia on the weekend.
Do join us for the grand finale tomorrow, when four world champions will be crowned with the same emotional impact as these magic moments for Robert Scheid and Bruno Prada, our two new heroes of the star class.
Robert Scheid, world champion in the star, today, he made it look easy.